prepare my grilled balsamic and blueberry glazed salmon with a pan-seared Parmesan-coated vegetable medley. Now, I have here 2 5-ounce skinless salmon fillets, and they were, like I told you a little bit earlier, they were about as fresh as you can get because they were swimming right before I got them. Okay, so they were, that's how how much fresh and that this product is. And I always recommend that you choose a wild-caught salmon, and also that you make sure that they really truly are fresh. One of the things that I use is basically my smell. So if it smells fishy, you know, it's really not necessarily as fresh as you would want it to be, okay? So it's just not that. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of give it a little bit of some flavoring on this, on our lovely. The first thing I do is I have a little extra virgin olive oil. And the extra virgin olive oil will scorch if you get it too high so that when you're cooking. So that's the reason I'm using a medium heat on my grill. And I have just coated it with some garlic butter pan coating. I'm adding a little bit of lemon juice to my olive oil. And my olive oil is about 1 tablespoon. Lemon juice about 1 tablespoon as well. I've got a teaspoon of lemon pepper. I have some paprika, about a teaspoon of paprika. I have a teaspoon of garlic and a teaspoon of nutritional yeast. Now, Joan is with us today, and considering that she cannot handle the black pepper, I'm going to leave it off of one of these, and we're just going to put a little olive oil on that to make sure that it cooks as well. So we're going to, what I like to do is I like to take my salmon, and I will kind of give it a good little coating all around, completely all the way around on every side, and then we're just going to basically sit it on there. I try my best, and since she's allergic, I'm going to remove my gloves and put on a fresh pair. Put this bowl out of the way. Grab a fresh pair of gloves so that we can make sure that we take care of this one. Anytime you have a food allergy or anything like that in your family, you can always just modify the recipe and leave things out so that everybody can enjoy the meal. Okay, on this one right here, I'm basically going to just add a little bit of oil and a little bit of lemon juice, basically. That's all the thing I'm going to add to it. Now, I've done put my bowl down there. It's good because I'm going to use this bowl for that. Just a little bit there and a little bit of lemon juice for that. Probably about a quarter of a teaspoon. It doesn't take much for. All right. And we're just going to kind of give that a good little coating. You wouldn't want to let the salmon to sit in the oil and the lemon juice because that citrus acid will cook it, and that wouldn't be a good idea. And I'm going to put it over here on this far side, so to keep that away. Let's cut the heat up just a tad. Now it's time to, this is one of the things I love using, these little parchment things, because guess what? Now I can clean off and I'm ready to go again. And see, and then that's out of the way. Okay, turn that up just a little bit. I must be having a little bit of a power deficit on my, okay, now gloves again. I should take stocking gloves. I screwed up and didn't do that somewhere down the line, but that's all right, you know, because we do go through a bunch of them, but that is why we get 100 on our score up there for every time, so that we make sure everybody's taken care of and everybody's health and issues are taken care of as well. Now for my glaze to go on top, I have turned my conduction cooktop on. We're going to basically put it down to about a medium heat. I'm going to add in here my frozen wild Maine blueberries. There's no oil in there at this point in time. There's no need for it because there's a lot of liquid as far as that goes in this. All right, and I'm just going to give it a little bit of stir, okay? Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little lemon juice. And what I added there was probably about 2 teaspoons. I've got a tablespoon of Italian balsamic vinegar. And I've got a tablespoon of raw honey. I'm going to add all all that together. All that out there. Yoki. Now, let's go ahead and pull that down. All right. Take these off. Right here. And let this get to a good little simmer. You want to be careful not to overcook the salmon. Basically, one of the best ways to wash your salmon is to allow it to cook approximately at the medium-high heat. If it seems to be cooking too fast, then just cut it back just a little bit. But you want it to get it until you can see where that is starting to change colors coming up through here. Flip it over, and this will probably take between 3 to 5 minutes on this side, on each side, and then you'll be ready for your salmon. It'll be perfect. You don't want to overcook it. You want it to be nice and moist, but yet cooked all the way through. You can smell my balsamic vinegar here. Should be able to, because I sure can. Now, that is one thing I love about our experience here at the spa, is we have smell-o-vision. I need a fan blowing it that way for you. You're just going to let that cook a little bit until it gets pretty good and boiled. Then I'm going to add, basically what I have here is some blueberry juice that I mix just about a tablespoon of cornstarch in. A lot of times people ask me, they say, why didn't you just use water? I said, I would have, but it would have diluted my flavor. So why not just use the juice from, the blueberry juices from when it thaws out. So that's another little trick that you can use there. See how we're looking on that side? Oh, it's starting to come up a little bit. I want to cook it, like I said, slow. I want to reach the juices down a little bit more. I'm going to add my juice to it. I think my cornstarch is still to the bottom. You ever do that? Mm-hmm. I'm telling you. I know I started pouring it in there and I wouldn't have had no cornstarch. That would not have been good. When you add it to something hot, it's always best to dissolve the cornstarch in something a little cool first before you add it in there, because if you just put powder cornstarch in that, it's going to be so lumpy and you're not going to like that experience. So make sure you add it to a liquid first and then put it in there. Alrighty. Now I have to cut the heat back up for it to start boiling in order for it to get a little bit thicker. And it's all ready to that point. We're going to turn the element off. Okay, and you can see that, you see there, how that's thickened up almost like a jelly consistency. Just from that right there. And that's what's going to be on top of your salmon. Okay, now while that is still cooking there, in that little bit of time, we're going to do our vegetables. So what I have here is I have my seasoning, which is Parmesan cheese, a little bit of a paprika, and some nutritional yeast. I also have some braised liquid aminos. It's time for me to flip that salmon right here, especially. Okay. What you're going to do is just basically flip it over. Look at that. Ain't that plum gorgeous? I've done this a few times, y'all. And you can see this one doesn't have the spices as this one does because of the allergies that but it will still taste, still taste good for you. Okay, so for our vegetables, I'm going to give my little pan a little spray of my garlic butter spray again. Turn the power on, reduce it down to about a low hot heat. I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil, probably about a tablespoon there. And then I'm going to throw in my peppers first because they take a little bit longer to cook. Alright, so I'm going to do that. Kind of toss them around. We're going to throw in the squash and the zucchini. Toss that out. You got just a little bit of braised liquid aminos. I don't know if you know what this is. This is like liquid protein. You spray that on your vegetables, it gives it a more of a similar to a soy sauce flavor to it. Just kind of get that in there, and then we'll cut this back up now so they can start cooking pretty good. might have to add or put a lid on that in just a second. We can turn these off now. I'll let them finish cooking over here on this burner. I have to kind of remember my burner goes this way and under that, so that right there is perfect. Once to check your salmon, you just kind of basically check it with a fork to see if it's flaking nicely, making sure that it is. So you don't, and make it, and so bear in mind, you don't want to overcook it. So I'm going to set this one, again, off to the side, right here. Turn in all this moisture. Your vegetables are also very important. That there are certain vegetables that require a little bit of heating in order for them to be, in order for you to be able to absorb some of the nutrients that are found naturally in the food. So, and peppers are one of them. And you know, a lot of it is because of the vitamin C that is in there and that amount. So there are some nutrients that actually are in certain vegetables that require you to cook them. People ask all the time, you know, many times if they ate raw, would they get a higher nutritional value? Well, it just depends on what the vegetable is, you know, within that spectrum. Do we have any questions from anybody today? Anybody got any questions?
How much blueberry was in there?
How much blueberry? About a half a cup. I'm sorry, I didn't include that, did I? I'm sorry. Yeah. Half a cup of wild Maine frozen blueberries is what I use. Someone asked me the other day, they said, why do you use wild versus the fresh? I said, the nutritional value is higher. There's less sugar, there's more fiber, there's higher antioxidants. A lot of people don't realize also that with frozen blueberries, the antioxidant level actually is higher than frozen blueberries. And a lot of it is contributed to the fact that they are required by their suppliers to actually allow the blueberries to ripen further on the vine for freezing and preserving and things of that nature. So the antioxidant level is actually higher in that aspect.
So did you say that the peppers, bell peppers, the vitamin C doesn't become accessible until it's heated?
It needs to be heated just a little bit in order for the body to absorb it more efficiently. Yeah.
So when you eat raw peppers
not as much, exactly.
What other vegetables that can you think of off the top of your head are more nutritious if they're cooked?
Things like Brussels sprouts, you know, they are broccoli, you know, those items, yeah. A lot of your cruciferous vegetables need to be steamed, you know, a little bit. I don't mean to be cooked completely, I mean just allow some heat to get on them to the point where that they are, it's almost like the enzymes begin to release and it's easier for your body to absorb them when it's in that state.
Well, that's just better
than
it anyway.
Yes, I think so too. And also a lot of the natural flavors are enhanced, you know, a little bit to me when they are heated or blanched rather than just, I mean, I do love a crunchy pepper now, don't get me wrong. I love to eat them, you know, with and crunchy peppers and cucumbers and things of that nature, but I also like mine that are cooked as well.
So like broccoli to me and cauliflower, and they taste, even when you're dipping with them, they taste better if you blend them.
Yeah, exactly. They do, they sure do. All right, now so here we're going to add our seasoning. We have our paprika again. I love to use paprika because paprika comes from the sweet bell pepper, and sweet bell peppers are so high in vitamin C. So adding the paprika to it is definitely enhancing that flavor. Also have some garlic in there. Do I put it on there? Yeah, I put it on the cheese. Yep. Mm-hmm. All right, let me say my daughter does.
Can I tell you a really healthy snack since we're in a moment of pie?
Yeah.
That I love in the summer here is blanched okra. If you just take okra, which like most people don't like because they think it's slimy, take it in a sec, but it's so, there's so much of it, you know, in here, and some, you take it, you blanch it, and then take, you know, put it in hot water, pull it right out, and roll it in kosher salt, and it's just the most crunchy, delicious vegetable. I just love, I mean, you want to talk about a healthy, delicious snack. Try it.
No slime?
No slime at all. Crunches and it tastes good. Even all over the place.
Having tomatoes and a little smoked sausage.
All right, ladies. And do I have a gentleman in the house?
Nope.
Ladies, this is our lovely entree. I'm going to top it now with our blueberries because you cannot leave that off. Look at this.
Wow.
Have you tried any other fruits with it?
I have. I've tried some raspberries.
Now, if you don't use salmon, is there other fish that
tastes
good with it?
Yeah, you can use halibut or even some cod. You can use that too if you'd like to use it.
And how much balsamic did you add to the...
I had about 2 tablespoons of balsamic. Alrighty, I'm going to... If anyone would like to take a photo, please feel free to.